Okay. So, I just bought the battle pass for this, so I got this guy. Well, I bought it yesterday. I've only used this guy once. But, so I got this guy like a day early, and I don't have to spend renown for him. So that's nice. So I'm just gonna hop into a match and see what he does. Cause I mean, I died like instantly when I used him, so I have no idea what he does. We're gonna find out together. If, you know, if he finds a match. So this season is Crimson Heist. Floris. What's his bio? Yeah, I ain't reading all that. I mean, sometime I will. Maybe at the end of the video I will. So he's probably like, so 2 meters is about 6 feet 3 inches. So he's probably like 6 feet tall. Maybe like, maybe 5'11". In feet, 5 feet 11 inches, maybe 6 feet 1. It's one of those three. Okay, I'm just gonna read this while we start going into match. In life, you have to commit to the things that make you happy. For me, that's robbing the rich and corrupt. Okay, but we'll read the rest later, I guess. I think I'm getting sick, or it's just allergies. I'm pretty sure it's allergies, because I don't think I'm getting sick. But it sucks, because then it makes me sound like a little baby. I'm gonna go as Doc. I'll go as Castle. And then I'm gonna actually start doing challenges for this game, which is kind of funny. I never thought I'd be seeing myself doing challenges on this game. But we're gonna be doing them, so. Big Daddy Gaming, nice name. Okay, we don't need to read all of these. If you read this, then you'll know. Just like, boop, get rid of that. Okay, this guy obviously has McDonald's Wi-Fi or something. Load, please. Mr. Graham Cracker, dude, you need to get better Wi-Fi. Or a better PC. Or both. And a better connection, because this is embarrassing, Mr. Graham Cracker. Ah, there you go. Took him long enough. Okay.
Secure the area. Bombs protected. Op 4 located a bomb. Protect it.
Finish reinforcing the wall!
Let's pick this up. That was a little embarrassing.
10 seconds to insertion. 5 seconds left.
Door barricade deployed!
Deploying the base!
Op 4 has located a bomb.
Damn. Okay, lit me up, bro. My teammate did.
Reload!
Enemy drone moving into scan. Starting timer. You have been exposed. A bomb has been located by officers.
Just gotta chill right here. I think there's somebody
over here. Last off the user located. Disable it.
Shoot. Let's just do this real quick. Shoot, dude, what the heck?
Bomb defusing device is disabled.
Well, shoot. I gotta do this and then this. We gotta get out of this junk. Dang it. Alright, just ignore that. Sorry. Randomly started playing. Sorry. Let's go into here. Let's go as Doc with the shotgun, even though I hate shotguns. They're garbage, so. Okay, well, this one is starting now. Let's go. Sweet. Okay, well, I mean, I guess the McDonald's Wi-Fi, or the guy still has McDonald's Wi-Fi, so that's fine. Dang.
Secure the area.
Oh yeah, if anyone made it this far, like the video please and subscribe. I'd rather you guys subscribe than like the video, because I mean, likes don't mean nothing to me right now, at least.
Like,
bop, 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 bop. Head into here.
Time for 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds and counting.
Deploying the base.
Bomb location secure.
Deployed.
deploy it.
Oh my goodness.
Enemy scan inbound. Starting the timer.
Nest ready!
Friendly, last operator standing. Your location has been compromised.
We lost. That's too bad. Okay, so that one's done. Let's just go here. I'll go Floris, so that I can maybe see what he's like, I guess. So there's 8 seconds left. If these two guys would just, you know, actually pick their characters, then they'd load quicker, but you know, it's fine. Yeah, it's fine. Oh, yeah. Oh, that one was quick. Sweet. Let's go. Good job, guys. Good job not having McDonald's Wi-Fi.
You need to use your drone to locate a bomb.
Okay, let's just head this way.
Drone has located a bomb.
Can you not break that window no more? Like, seriously?
Get bopped.
Shoot.
The diffuser is now secured. No longer in your possession. One friendly operator remaining.
Due to unforeseen events, the border is now closed. Please remove yourself from the premises. في حال وقوع أحداث
Oh, that's retarded.
Op 4 eliminated. eliminated all friendlies.
No, that sucked. Kinda figured he would still be in that little corner, camping like a little loser, but I guess he decided not to be a little loser, but he decided to be a big loser. Okay, I can almost guarantee you that someone is gonna try and rush us. At least one person, maybe two. Because there's only three of us and five of them, so we can still win this.
We need to locate a bomb.
I believe in me. What? Well,
insertion in 10 seconds.
Tried.
Insertion in 5 seconds. Proceed to bomb location and defuse it. Friendly operator remaining. We have been eliminated.
I'm such a noob. I thought we were gonna win that one too. It's fine. I don't really mind. I'll just go ahead and do that. And I'll go ahead and finish raiding this dude's bio. And then we'll be done. Okay, so we read this already. So, providing for his mother as her health slowly declined, Lucero was unfulfilled with work in the public sector and unimpressed with military school. This drew him to burglary as an occupation, and he found purpose in robbing powerful criminals to give back to the poor. Operating in the florist district of Buenos Aires, Lucero's notoriety grew, and he came to be known as the man from Flores. When his identity was exposed, he had to flee. Specialist Eliza Ash Cohen offered him asylum in the United States. In exchange, he provided evidence against Buenos Aires' most ruthless crime lords. With a new life in Los Angeles, Lucero opened his own food truck, from which he operated heists for 5 years. When Cohen became aware of his activities, she offered him a seat at her table and a stable future in which he could build a family. Psychological report. Because of his stubborn and perfectionist nature, Specialist Santiago Flores Lucero struggles to separate the personal from the professional. He likes to put people at ease with regularly cracks jokes, but he often gets in his own way by overanalyzing mundane situations. I understand the impulse to cover all possibilities, considering his mother was killed in retaliation of his activities in Buenos Aires. He needed to realize that he's in good hands here in the long run. I'm certain his intentions with the others, particularly Specialist Eliza Ash Cohen, which whom he's already familiar, will help him let down his guard. I'm about to sneeze, sorry. Okay, as a bonding exercise, I had Santiago cook his favorite Argentinian meals for us to share, and it became easier to dive into deeper subjects. I learned that despite his charms, he's not afraid to be vocal about social issues and his efforts to give back to improvised communities. I don't know if I said that right, it's fine. He also confessed that his marriage was as much of a surprise to him as it was to me. Maybe in time we'll find out why his husband, all that stupid gay faggot, isn't bothered by his criminal career. We also delved into his childhood shaped who he is today. While he adheres to this traditional idea of makeismo, I don't know how to say that, he's quick to point out that his mother taught him to think independently. He has no memories of his father and his political activism, but he likes to talk about how his mother was proud of him for also doing what he felt right, regardless of the consequences. I'm glad Santiago has been taking the time to observe everyone else's methods in order to improve his own. He learned a lot at Colegio Militar in El Palomar, and I'm sure his years of criminal activity helped him in that regard. However, I believe budding friendships with specialists Grace Dokebi Nab and Tori Gridlock Ferius, based mostly on technology and food, will be greatly beneficial. Dr. Harishva Harry Pandley, Director of Rainbow Training, Colegio Militar de la Nación. Relative experience, various heists in Buenos Aires, various heists in Los Angeles. Notes, device, RCE, Radaro charge, operator specialist Santiago Flores Lucero, evaluation lead specialist Eliza Ash Cohen. I don't usually get involved in these evaluations, but considering how nervous Lucero was at the idea of a stranger handling his toys, I assured him I'd oversee the process. That being said, I enlisted the help of specialist Elena Mira Alvarez and Shuhart Fuse Kesikbeyev, and I'm confident that they'll take good care of the RCE Retero. As they worked together, I watched them turn a rudimentary but effective tool into something worthy of tactical operations. The base function remains, and Lucero will be able to remotely pilot his favorite device, but as Fuse told me, with so much enthusiasm, it will now be much more reliable. As he explained, the new casing is fitted with a mechanism that secures the device when it's armed, protecting it from firearms. Fuse also integrated a fast-acting adhesive that serves to lodge the explosive in place, which Lucero will appreciate. I'm eager to see it in action on the field once he gets the hang of these upgrades. Specialist Eliza Ash Cohan. Okay, well, let's see what I got. Oh, sweet, I got a challenge news. Okay. Nice. So I have a 1-day booster now. Okay, well, that's gonna be the end of the video, so like, subscribe. If you don't want to like, then just subscribe.